Have you guys locked in on a deck yet?
Yeah.
We don't need to discuss what the deck is, but have you locked in on a deck?
Oh, yeah. No, I think I'm playing Splinter Twin.
Oh, wow. Straight up.
Yeah, it's not a Pro Tour.
Wasn't someone
I'm streaming, like, this is all my testing.
Wasn't someone suggesting Splinter Twin? Wrapter, were you saying something about Splinter Twin a few weeks ago on Magic TV? Blue-red Splinter Twin?
No, it wasn't.
Someone was saying
about how bad it is.
Someone was talking about how good that deck was and how with the bannings it was going to get much better. I thought it was you, Wrapped. Was that me? Oh my god! And all of a sudden, Paul's playing it. All of a sudden, Paul's playing it. Oh, it's okay, man. It's okay, man. I'm here for you.
Basically, my plan is to avoid the junk decks, which is there's probably going to be a lot of.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think I have a reasonable game plan to like do well and you know maybe leverage. Like, you know, all the decisions that we're going to have to make against you to make it to, like, a close to 50-50 matchup.
Right.
But the reason why I like Splinter Twin is because I think it's very good against, you know, many of the other decks in the format outside of junk.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's really that. Or actually, I've been having a reasonable amount of success playing Infect as well. Infect is the real deal.
Infect is awesome. I would absolutely be on the Infect plan, just FYI.
I think there's going to be more people kind of looking at ways to beat Infect because it was kind of like the...
Under the radar.
Well, it was kind of the deck that broke out at the Pro Tour.
Yeah. I mean, so. It was one of the... I mean, it was two in the top 10, but not in the top 8, right? I think that...
Right.
So it's, you know, it was...
But Team Pantheon played it. When Pantheon plays the deck, you get Finkel off a storm, people are going to be looking at...
Well, and the other way to look at it, though, is Pantheon play the deck. That's, like, some of the best players in Magic today and zero in the top 8. So, you know, you got to play it better than they did, maybe.
There's Wrapter. Not really cards that are, like, insane against Infect that you can just put in your sideboard if you want to beat Infect.
There's
like,
a few cards.
Like, something like Dark Blast is good, but there's no card that's just, like, game over. Like a Rule of Law against Storm or a
Yeah, there's not a card that's game over, but there are cards that are effect. Well, I saw Owen playing against a Knight of Souls Betrayal.
Yeah. That one's pretty good.
He did not win that game. I mean, they have Nature's Claim out of the board, but yes. If you can resolve a Knight of Souls Betrayal before dying...
Jeez. Wrapter.
Well, I haven't played a game of Modern since the Pro Tour.
That puts you on Abzan.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna play the same deck. So hope to play against all Cheons.
Have you built your sideboard yet?
No.
That's the question.
Yeah.
The question is
the sideboard's definitely gonna change.
Yeah.
But I have not actually taken a look at it.
So well, time is short. When are you flying out?
Friday.
Well, I guess you have an extra day. That's right. Yeah. I'm flying out tomorrow because we got set up on Friday. But I guess you have the extra day, so use your time wisely. Speaking of Modern, if you guys haven't checked out the Mothership and seen the two articles on there, I highly recommend you do it. Start with Paulo. PV has written a great article on Modern. Sperling wrote an equally great rebuttal to PV's article. Have you guys had a chance to read those articles?
Mm-hmm.
They're awesome. PV's article surprisingly kind of takes issue with Modern. And when I first saw it, I was surprised because Modern, with its expansive, non-rotating card pool, I thought was something that was more favored by professional, the pros. And PV has some problems with Modern. What did you think of PV's take on Modern?
He raises valid points, but I disagree that those are like problems with the format. I look at them as features. Like, I think having a format that has like a ton of diversity in the different kinds of decks,
mm-hmm.
like each deck just being, you know, 3% of the field or whatever, is awesome. I love that the decks are like doing very different and unique things.
Sure.
Like, when you play a match of Modern, you're not just playing against a deck that's full of creatures and removal spells every round. And that's great. I love that change of pace. I love actually that some cards have like very swingy values, that sideboard cards have like tremendous impact in a match. Because if there's a deck that you want to beat, you can sideboard cards and you can beat it.
Mm-hmm.
So I really like that aspect of it. In terms of like the actual gameplay, it may not be the best because it hinges too much on those cards. But I think it's actually really interesting that the cards do have these like very different values, and it changes the way you play the games because the games become so much about very specific cards, like your Shatterstorm against Affinity,
mm-hmm.
things like that.
I thought it was interesting, you know. Paulo did write this article, and some of the stuff he was advocating, like, you know, kind of bringing unban Ancestral Visions because he thought that Treasure Cruise was, you know, Treasure Cruise
too good.
brought more semblance of balance to the format. But he admits Treasure Cruise was too good, but Ancestral Vision would kind of possibly be just right. Also believes that, you know, bringing Jace and Bloodbraid at the same time into the format would be good. Obviously, we've talked a lot about that on this show. And I do agree with that at least. But I think, you know, my takeaway was very, very similar to yours, Wrapter. And I think Sperling could have done better to get it. Sometimes Sperling's too smart for his own good. And and kudos to Matt. What happened is PV wrote this article and it caught fire. Like just everybody was talking about it. Everybody was commenting on it. And so Andy Cooperfaust, our director of content, editor-in-chief here at Channel Fireball, sent something out to the Channel Fireball Facebook page saying, hey, would anyone like to write a rebuttal? Unsurprisingly, like before he even hit send on the Facebook, Sperling snap calls. Snap's like, yes. Here's my first draft. Wow.
Yeah.
So Sperl put together a great rebuttal article. But one of the things I think that gets lost is exactly the point you're making, which is, hey, Paulo, maybe everything you're saying is right about modern, and maybe it's not something that they need to fix about the format. Maybe you just don't like the format. Maybe it's just not the format, you know, you like. And I think he's saying, I don't like the format, but maybe it doesn't need to be fixed. You know, you can eat a bunch of ice cream and keep looking for the right flavor, but maybe you just don't like ice cream. I don't know.
Well, Paulo has the exact opposite problem, actually.
Yeah, he loves ice cream. I love ice cream, too. It's so funny. I was just thinking about this weekend. I had Dole Whip and a chocolate sundae. I was like, man, I love ice cream and frozen treats.
Ice cream is the best.
Ice cream is unbelievable. It's interesting. I think that in terms of what Paulo was upset about was what you were saying. Is like you show up to a tournament, and if you don't pack the right sideboard card, something's going to get you. And there's so much diversity. And this is so weird because normally you don't have an issue with diversity in a format. That's a plus. When we talk about standard, we're like, oh my God, there's so many decks to play. It's great. But it's, you know, Paulo's argument is there was too much diversity of unfair decks. The linear strategies, because of the large card pool, were too overwhelming. And if you didn't have that Stony Silence or Creeping Corrosion or, you know, the White Ley Line or, you know, whatever it was, the Core Firewalker to stop the matchup, you were just going to get steamrolled. And that made for no fun. I think, you know, it actually adds a whole other element. You know, sideboarding becomes so much more important, and the decisions you make about how you craft that sideboard become immensely important. One of the things he was advocating was for a 20-card sideboard. What do you think of a 20-card sideboard, Paul?
It doesn't sound as crazy as, like, if for, you know, people are so used to the 60-15, but it doesn't seem that crazy for the modern format. And I'm saying that because, you know, Paulo's whole argument was, look, there's just so many ridiculously powerful linear decks in the format, and you can only pack enough sideboard for, you know, a few of the decks.
Right.
And you're just going to be like, well, I'm just going to lose to these decks. Mm-hmm. And he didn't like the fact that you're just basically playing matchup lottery, where, you know, oh, I'm playing against Living End. I don't have any graveyard hate. I'm screwed.
Sure.
He just didn't like that. And, you know, and all the great sideboard cards, there's not a lot of splash damage. These good sideboard cards are good against, like, one deck.
Right, they're very focused.
You have your Creeping Corrosion. It's good against Affinity. Stony Silence, decent against Tron, which is why I like it a lot. But, like, you know, Core Firewalker.
Very targeted, right.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And I think he just didn't like that portion. And I do kind of agree with him with that. Like, you can pack more versatile sideboard cards, but then they're not going to have as much of an impact in the matchups that you bring it in. Mm-hmm. And then that just means that you're just not going to be a favorite against anything because you don't have those heavy-hitting sideboard cards. So going up a little bit, not going nuts, not having a 30 card, but 20 cards might be reasonable. I can see how I can at least see where he's coming from when he says 20-card sideboard could be a thing.
What would your take on that, Rapid?
So if unfair decks were running rampant and just you had to play an unfair deck and, you know, get the right matchups or whatever in Modern, then I would be in favor of that. Like, I think that would be a great way to give the fair decks a boost and help them compete. But that's not the case.
Yeah.
The linear decks are very much held in check. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, the deck that comes out of nowhere and does well in a tournament, like, that catches people off guard, like, that's going to happen every now and then in the format.
That's what's great about Magic.
Yeah, but that's awesome. The fact that you can, you know, bring the forgotten about deck and show up with it and do great with it is awesome.
Like,
it's what actually keeps the format fresh despite it being the same cards year after year after year.
Exactly.
So I think that's awesome. And I think that having the limited sideboard will keep it rotating around as far as what flavor of unfair decks are popular. And I just don't think that you want the format to be about the fair decks. I think that having all these, like, linear decks that do their unique things is a cool feature, and you don't want to take that away from it.
And
just, like, the format right now is so much better than just a format of all junk mirrors all the time. That would be awful.
Right, and I think that, you know, there is a format for fair decks that's standard.
Yeah.
And this is what modern's about.
Don't turn modern into standard. Right. Modern's great.
We already have standard. The other thing, the other takeaway I'll have in Wrapter C, I don't know if I got this totally wrong. First of all, let me be clear. PV has forgotten more good games of Magic than I've ever played. Okay, he's unbelievable. So that colors kind of how I read it, because the guy's a Hall of Famer, guy's unbelievable, and I mean, if you talk to him, he just understands the game and has very strong opinions about the game, but they're well thought out. But it seemed at points reading it, particularly, you know, with the Ancestral Vision thing, that what he's looking for is a deck that has generic answers to everything, which is really control, which a lot of very good Magic players look for. They're not looking for discrete targeted answers out of the sideboard or in the main deck, two decks. They're looking for widespread answers. And of course, control, particularly blue, mono blue control, is the best way to do that. And that's not possible in Modern.
Well, it's not the best way to do it in Modern. The best way to do that in Modern is Thoughtseize and Abrupt Decay.
Right.
Yeah.
No, that's what I'm saying.
I mean, that's the control deck. Like, the blue control decks are just not good.
And I think that was, to me, reading it, I thought he was taking issue with that.
No, I don't. He doesn't care that it's the blue cards that are bad.
Okay.
The problem is that there's just very few cards that are like generically good against all the linear decks. Mm-hmm. Like you are very limited. At, like you have to play Thoughtseize Abrupt Decay. There's no other options.
Right.
Yeah. It would be more interesting if there were a wider array of fair cards that you could play that could successfully interact with, you know, the wide variety of decks that are out there. And that kind of does lead itself to blue, because blue is good at doing that, or has been historically.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But it isn't in Modern right now.
Maybe they can just, you know, let Counterspell, like, somehow reprint Counterspell, or would that be a thing, you know?
Nope.
Just blue counter target spell.
That card, it's too good.
Counterspell.
In modern, it's getting progressive. It's getting progressive.
But it would be good.
It would definitely be good. I don't know about too good.
Right. I think it would make the blue decks, like, playable. I think right now the blue red white control decks just it did very poorly at the Pro Tour. It did not.
Yeah, but
well.
You know, it's not about control. You know, I mean, it's about where else is it going to fit in? Because mana in the format is insane. You can play whatever you want. Counterspell is not a control card.
Yeah. You can put that in your zoo deck.
Yeah, exactly. You know, you can get Geist in there, you can get Counter. You play your Splinter Twin. You playing Splinter Twin?
Yeah, well, yeah.
Well, that's why he wants to.
Yeah, there you go.
That's why I like Splinter Twin, though, because it basically, you know, tries to play a little bit of that control game.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably, in my opinion, it's probably the best, like, you know, control deck, like blue control deck in the format, because I think I like it over blue red white, because it's got, you know, the blue red white deck sometimes it just it takes too long to win, and then like people can just draw it and beat you, whereas the Splinter Twin deck you can actually just kill people on turn four.
Right.
Yeah. Because of the wide variety of things that you need to be prepared to face, I think trying to play like a long game blue control deck,
it's not
for game ones. This is not realistic.
Mm-hmm, yeah. I agree.
Like you need either have a Tarmogoyf or a Splinter Twin kill to like kill them quickly. So I think Splinter Twin is great for doing that. And then the great thing about Splinter Twin is that you just get to board into the control deck post-board.
Right.
Like, you become way less of a combo deck and just way more of a control deck against everything.
You get Blood Moons,
once you get to actually have the cards that interact well against whatever your opponent's doing.
And that's just that's another effect of having such powerful linear strategies. Control is going to fold to that because you cannot stop all of them, which I think is by design in Modern. Fast forward to Sperling's rebuttal of PV's article, also very good. I mean, you should read both these. We're not going in depth enough to do either of these articles really justice. But Sperling's article, when I read it, and you know, Sperling's an attorney, and he's a good attorney. And when you read it, you go, this guy's an attorney, because the first thing he does, which I think is it's so much like an attorney. He's like, I'm not going to argue with what you've said. I'm not going to argue with the main principles of what you said. I'm gonna argue with the fact that I don't think you clearly stated your principles. It's like the argument before the argument. Like, first of all, you weren't clear enough with what you were advocating. Okay, now let me go into what you were advocating, which was so attorney-like, and I felt bad for PV because you know PV's like, really? I this is what I was doing. Like, why? Out of nowhere you say this, but I think Matt was very honest with himself and said, okay, enough with that. Let's move on to what I believe is the case. And I think he could have been more forceful, because I do think he agrees with what you've been saying, Wrapter, but I don't think he was as clear as he needed to be with it. And I think, you know, he was more on the lines of, look, you know, you're complaining, for instance, about not being able to play Cryptic Command or something like that, and that's what your real complaint is. Not that, hey, I just don't like formats with very linear overpowered strategies. What did you think of Sperling's rebuttal?
Yeah, basically what you said.
Yeah. It's good. It's a very good read. And again, Matt, I mean, he cranked that thing out immediately.
Yeah, that came out fast.
Yeah, yeah. It did. Also, if you guys are reading those articles, check out the comments. Martel basically has a mini article in the comments. He's very, very active in his discussion. I don't want to go into what he said and what his comments are, but check it out. I, for one, am a huge fan of Modern. I don't play anywhere near as much Magic as I wish I had the time to. I think it's an amazing format. I love watching it. And I love seeing things like Infect come up out of nowhere in the Pro Tour. And you're like, oh my God, John Finkel's playing Infect. And that's the kind of stuff you don't see in Standard. And that's what I love about Modern. You know, it is a slightly different format now, again, because of the Pro Tour. You know, if there was no Modern Pro Tour, we may see things like Pod and Treasure Cruise still in. But we have a Pro Tour, and there's an integrity of the Pro Tour that has to be protected. So that's what happens. What's your take on Modern? Thumbs up or thumbs down, Chion?
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up? Come on, you gotta like it. Come
I mean,
on,
I loved Modern.
Yeah.
And then after testing for the Pro Tour, I took it down a few notches. Partly because, you know, like, it was just really hard to figure out what was good to play. And we just couldn't figure it out. And it frustrated a lot of the people that were testing for the Pro Tour, at least within our group, because we didn't play any of the Infect decks or any of the other linear decks.
Right.
And given the choices or given the availability of what I was basically had to choose from, I really wouldn't be that happy with any of the decks that we had, at least for the Pro Tour.
Modern, thumbs up, thumbs down. You guys are playing in a Modern event this weekend, so thumbs up or thumbs down?
Overall, thumbs up. Okay. With a big caveat, the big problem with Modern in my eyes is just that it doesn't change. It's staying the same forever because all the cards are non-rotating. It's just always going to be the same format, and new sets do very little to change it. It's really hard to get new cards played in Modern, which is a problem like as a Pro Tour format because you just don't get to play with new cards. Like,
sure.
That's really bad for coverage.
It's a bit ironic now because Cons as a set had tremendous effect on the format. So I think your statement's correct. Timing
but
be
Fey Reforged did not.
Yes.
Even though it was poised to. Delve is still, even without Treasure Cruise, like other Delve cards are still like that's a great mechanic
Very
for
good.
Modern.
Yeah, right. Tasker was like
Tasker went right into the format.
Gourmet Angler.
But overall, you know, like 1% of the cards, less than 1% of the cards played in the tournament were from the new set.
That's
really bad for highlighting the new cards.
That's the issue of the beast.
So certainly that's an issue with it. And just the fact that it's never changing, like my favorite thing in Magic is exploring a new format. And you never get to do that with Modern because it's just never a new format. The only way it is if there's like huge changes to the banned and restricted list.
And they are pretty aggressive about that, I'd say, for Modern. You still have Jeskai Ascendancy in there. But.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're not very... They were aggressive with it at first.
And you think
and
they
I think they're not anymore.
They backed off.
I thought they should have banned Pod, like...
Yeah, like, they should have banned Pod much earlier if they were going to be aggressive about it, right?
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you this, because this is coming up in the chat, and this was also in Sperling's article. One of the things he advocates for, potentially, to make Modern a better format, is to ban Fetches.
Well, yeah, that would be awesome.
Just
fetch lands are horrible. We've talked about this before.
Right.
But
just completely on board. Fetches should be banned in Modern. It would be a better format if they did that.
All the shuffling you have to do. Well, no.
The shuffling is the worst.
Like, that's the biggest reason to ban them. It's just the shuffling. You lose, you know, 15 minutes of your lives every single game, every single match of Modern you play, just to shuffling from fetch lands.
I think the question is about the health of the constructed format, not the timing.
Well, no, but that is the biggest issue with fetch lands. The health, they're also unhealthy just because you get to play whatever cards you want.
I mean, it's what makes
but
things unfair.
You can't play five colors. No, because that's a factor in favor of the fair decks.
You think
is being able to play answers in any color. It absolutely helps the junk decks way more than like the linear decks. The linear decks get to just cast the cards they want. They're generally
bird deck can easily just play only red birds.
Right.
Having access to all the cards doesn't matter as much for them. It's a much bigger deal being able to have all the sideboard cards you need.
But the linear strategies, apart from Affinity, let's take that aside because like it's not gonna play fetches. Do rely on powerful interactions between multiple colors to do well. And the reason they're so fast, I think, is because they do have access to fetches and shocks, and they don't care about damage, so they can just do it. You don't think it would impact any of those decks at all?
What deck? Burn doesn't really care. You can just play a two-color burn deck without fetches.
You think the fetches don't put that over with the red-white? Because you're going to keep white in there no matter what, right?
Yeah, I imagine white will be the
all
color.
All the linear decks are
usually
you like
have plenty
colors,
of just
though.
Good dual lands for a two-color deck. You don't need fetches to
But
make
it lets
that
you go down on your land count a bit, doesn't it?
No.
No, that
I mean, in terms
change.
Of what you're going to draw.
That's very not minimal, really yeah? a factor. Totally, yeah, that yeah. doesn't really
like,
matter.
Like, Infect could easily play 4 Yavimaya Coasts and 4 Breeding Pools or yeah. something.
And you don't think that would affect it, its efficacy at all?
Nope.
No, because it's taking more damage, but it doesn't care, mm-hmm. right? Whereas, you know, it's better for, like, the junk deck to be able to, like, fetch their basics or get their Shock Lens to be able to, like, play all their spells.
So fetches shouldn't go out if we want to hold the unfair linear decks in check.
Well, I just don't like the fetch lands in general.
But. Well, yeah, okay. Separate, forget about shuffle time. Forget about personal preferences. Fetches should stay in the format in order to keep some semblance of balance against the linear unfair decks. That's what you guys are both agreeing on.
Maybe.
Like, well, because losing them, you're saying, is going to hurt those
decks. Like, you
decks
can still just
more.
Play your three-color junk deck just fine without fetches.
Right.
It's really just the splash game for an off-color hate card. Mm-hmm. You know, putting
it does get a lot worse.
Like a slaughter game is in your Scape Shift deck.
Right.
Like, that kind of thing you can't do without fetch lands.
I mean, I'm all for making junk a little bit weaker so I can play Splinter Twins.
It's not going to happen before this weekend, Paul. I'm sorry. Yeah, sorry, yeah, buddy. Yeah. All right. Well, check out those two articles. They're a great read. We could spend hours talking about, you know, Modern, which we've done already so many times in the show. But those articles in particular, they're very, very great, great reads, very informative. The comments are unbelievable. I mean, there's like 300 comments on Paulo's article. I think there's 150 on Spurl's article. So check both of them out. Check out the comments. I mean, you're going to go down the rabbit hole, so make sure you got time and a cup of coffee and, I don't know, a slice of pizza or something. Maybe the pizza and then the coffee.
Coffee and pizza is kind of weird.
I'm drinking a lot of coffee these days.
I did read a sweet tweet.
Sweet tweet.
And basically, you were just like, all right, you know what? Fine. Let's just get rid of Modern. Replace it with the Team Pro Tour. Done. No. Come on!
I mean, no.
Come on!
We can have Modern in the Team Pro Tour.
I mean, if it was Unified Constructed? Unified Constructed I'd be a fan of.
What, Unified Modern?
Unified Modern. Nah, that wouldn't
be... It's not interesting. It's just that's all normal terrible. Modern. Yeah, there's just no overlap anyway.
It's got to be Unified Standard.
Yeah.
Or Unified Block. Just Standard Modern and Legacy or Block, like... Just do it like the old Team Worlds.
Yeah,
you know?
That'd be insane. Okay, yeah, I'm on board. Are you watching?
You're not gonna
this?
Have a split format. You're not gonna have like limited two.
Well, yeah, no, you have team drafts also.
Yeah, but you have the constructed.
So many formats you have to test for though.
Well, no, because for the matches you only have to test your format.
You only play Modern. You play Standard. You only play.
What about Unified Standard plus limited? I think that would be like a.
I mean,
well, the problem with Unified Standard is that you don't get real deck lists coming out of the event.
Yeah, you don't. It's not good for PTQs.
So unless
you have team PTQs,
nope.
For the Team Pro Tours,
nope.
Come on, team PTQs are great.
You would have to have team PTQs for the Team Pro Tour, though. I mean, you have to do that. Otherwise, it gets too wonky.
I talked to somebody about that, like the prospects of a Team Pro Tour, and the most difficult part was just setting up the PTQs. They're just so many now.
It's tough. And with the PPTQ system?
Because you can only have like so many teams actually qualify, right?
Right.
Like,
yeah.
So, but I mean, maybe with the PPTQ system, like, you just go top two teams of each region and that's not too bad.
Maybe. I mean, it's tough. It's tough.
Yeah,
I
just like the winning
yeah,
team.
Yeah, if it's like you can qualify for the sealed PTQ finals from mm-hmm. just like individual PPTQs, that might be interesting. Like, it might be able to actually happen.
I mean, I think, you know, you always have to ask yourself, if you're Wizards of the Coast, why are you going to take on that logistical headache? And the answer is,
because team tournaments are sweet.
They're great. But, you know, do it as an invitational. Do it as
a Look at how many people showed up for GP San Jose. It was like 2,000.
Yeah. No, I mean, team events are great.
Yeah.
But a team GP versus a team Pro Tour, which team PPTQs or some version of PPTQs have to feed into, completely different than a GP.
What if that's just what everybody wants?
Hey, well, email Wizards if that's what you want, but I'm telling you, it's a lot. Okay, moving along. Wrapter, top 3 Fate Reforged limited tips.